I am delighted to join my dear friend and distinguished colleague, Congressman Ackerman, in bringing to you the physical representation of the unanimously adopted welcome of your visit by the Congress of the United States. Each of us in Congress has a specialty. My specialty is human rights. It is not something I chose. It is something that evolved from my past and from the obvious fact that I am the only survivor of the Holocaust ever elected to the Congress of the United States. And for the last 20 years, as founding chairman of the Congressional Human Rights Caucus, which is a bipartisan organization encompassing practically all members, it's been my privilege, with the help of my friend Gary Ackerman, to fight for human rights across this globe, from the former Soviet Union to the former South Africa, to East Timor, Tibet, and scores of other places. Just yesterday, in Washington, I met with a wonderful group of Burmese who remembered that the legislation Gary and I supported, placing even more severe restrictions on the oppressive regime of Burma, expressing our outrage at the persecution of Aung San Suu Kyi, is just one of countless examples of how the cause of human rights always looks so bleak until people of your courage and your conviction and your principles and your values fight to overcome seemingly insuperable odds. I remember in the Soviet Union, when Sharansky was a prisoner, people kept telling me, it's a hopeless fight. And now Sharansky is a cabinet minister in Jerusalem. First hearing on the persecution of Catholics in East Timor, I was told there will never be an independent East Timor, and we have an ambassador to that small, young, independent country. And we had very little hope change the flavor and nature and character of an apartheid regime in South Africa until the day came and Nelson Mandela became president of their country. It was neither democratic nor successful. It was an authoritarian, poor country. And what you and the people of Taiwan have done is nothing short of a miracle. You have transformed an authoritarian and poor society into a thriving and functioning democracy which shares the values that built our great nation. Some years ago, before you became president, President Chen, I was reading the New York Times in the morning, and on the front page of the New York Times, there was a major story indicating that your predecessor, a distinguished alumnus of Cornell University, who was invited to receive an honorary degree at his alma mater, will not be allowed to visit. And I hit the roof. And I introduced the resolution, and with the help of Gary Ackerman and other colleagues, we succeeded in mandating that the Department of State issue a visa, and your predecessor went to Cornell and received his degree, which was the first breakthrough at the predecessor of your visit here today. Let me just say, I know I speak for all of my colleagues across the political aisle in saying we are looking forward to the day when you personally will be received as an honored guest in the White House. Affiliated agencies, not only in the United Nations, but as a full-fledged member of the international community that your country so deserves. Let me tell you, there is not the slightest doubt in my mind that my prediction of receiving you in the Congress and in the White House will come to pass. And while Taiwan will be a beneficiary of that development, the main beneficiary will be the globe as a whole, as the people of Taiwan make their incredible energies and talents available to building a more prosperous, more peaceful, more democratic, and more human rights respecting world. God bless us all.